Hello guys and welcome to Python Programming Tutorials by Amul's Academy. From many days, few people were asking me to make a video on decorators. So here I am. But to understand the decorator concept completely, we need to learn few other concepts also. To understand the decorator concept, first we need to know what is closure is. Okay. To understand this closure concept, we need to know what is namespace and variable scope. So what I'll do is, in this tutorial we'll discuss about the namespace and variable scope. In the next tutorial we'll learn about the LEGB rule, and next to next tutorial we'll learn about the closures, and finally we'll discuss about the decorators. Okay, so today's topic is nothing but namespace and variable scope. So what is names in Python? Why we use names in Python? So we'll use names in the program to identify an object, right? In the real life, we'll use name to identify a person. In the program, we'll use names to identify the object. So that's why they are called as identifiers. What kind of names we use in our program? Variable name, function name, class name, method name, right? These are all the identifiers. So we know what is name means. So now we need to know what is namespace is. So namespace is basically a system which will control all the names which we use in our program. Okay, it will assure that whatever the names we use is unique and it won't lead to any conflict. So that's nothing but, in the simple words, this namespace is a system which will control all the names in your program and it will allow us to reuse a name in your program. Okay, so we'll take the example. So first of all, why I want to reuse any name and what will happen if I reuse a name? So here I'll take a variable name. Okay, I'll take x equal to 4. Okay, x is a variable, 4 is the value. Now if I access the value of x, it will give 4. Done. So now in the next line, what I'll do is I'll take x as 5. I will assign a new value to this variable x. I'll use the same name. Now if I enter x and c, I'll get the value 5. And I lost the previous value 4. Okay, now I can't access this value 4 using variable x. So when we reuse a name, we may lose some data. That means we can't access that data. Okay, here we can't access 4 using x and also using any other variable, because previously 4 was stored in variable x. Now a new value is stored in that variable. So we can't access 4. Okay. So now you may say, okay, so fine, I won't reuse the name. Okay, I'll give two different names, like x is equal to 4 and I'll give y equal to 5. Okay, now I can access x also, y also, I can get 4 also, 5 also. Okay, then what is the work of namespace? I'll make sure that whatever the names I use are unique. I'll take care about that. Then why we need namespace? That is because if you are writing a 10 or 20 line code, okay, then that's okay. You can take care of the variable names and you can make sure that whatever the names you used are unique. All right. But if you are writing a long program and you are using external functions also, like you are importing the modules, then in that module you don't know which names you used. Okay, you may reuse the names in the different modules. In another case, half of the code is written by your friend and half is written by you. Then you don't know which names he used or she used in her part of code, right? So you may reuse that same names. So in that case, you can't sit and check all the names, right? In that cases, namespace comes to play and it will allow us to reuse the names. Okay. And a Python program contains multiple namespace. Okay, so there will be different types of namespace. First one is called as built-in namespace. Second one is called as global namespace. And third one is called as local namespace. When you call a function, it will create its own namespace, that is called as local namespace. When you import any module, when you use any module, that time it will create its own global namespace. So each module has its own namespace. That's why you can reuse names in different modules. And built-in is when you start the Python interpreter, built-in namespace is created. It contains all the built-in names. Okay, so I explained about the namespace, but we'll take a realistic example. Okay, so first is, like in the program I told you, if you are writing 20-30 line code, you are not importing any module, then you can take care about the names, right? You can take unique names and you can write the program. There will be no name collision. For this realistic example is, in your family, your parents and relatives won't repeat any name. Like, my name is Amulya. So my parents and my relatives won't name any of my cousin as Amulya. Okay, they'll search for the unique name, different name, right? So in our family, we can take care about that. There will be no name collusion. But if we are writing a long program and we are importing some modules and all, then we can't keep the eye on the uniqueness of the names, right? For that realistic example is, you will go to the college and there many person can have same names, right? Then how will you differentiate them? Using their surnames, right? I'm Amulya Shetty. Okay, some other student may have same name Amulya but different surname, like Sharma. Okay, so using that surname we can identify them, right? Here also we'll do the same thing. Here when we have different names, we'll identify them through namespace. Okay, in the module you can see, when we import module like this, like any module name, we'll call the function as module name dot function name. Okay, so that's nothing but we are telling the Python that this function belongs to this module. Okay, so each module has its own namespace, even though they have same names, but module name is different. That's why they can be reused. That's why names can be reused. For this, I'll take an example now here. I'll show you. I'll take first.py. It contains one function, okay? It is named function. It will print hi. Okay, here second.py. Function name is same, that is function. It will do something else. It will print. Okay, so in the main program, I'll import both this module. Import first, import second. Okay, here while calling this function, how I'll call? First, that is module name dot function. Second dot function. Here we can see, even though function name is same, but the module name is different, we are calling this function using module name also. That's like if two person has same name, we'll differentiate them using their surname, right? We'll mention their complete name. That's what we are doing here. Okay, that's why there will be no collusion. Okay, so this is about the namespace. So namespace will take care about the names and it will allow us to reuse the name in different namespace. So that's about the namespace. Next, as I said, we can use any names in the program, but we can't access any name from the any part of the program. Okay, so for example, I'll define a function, okay? Function name is f1. inside this I'll take x is equal to 4, print x. Okay, so next here I'll call that function, it will print 4. Now what I'll do is I'll try to access the value of x. It will give error, name error. Why? Because x is defined inside this function. It can be accessible only inside this function. We can't access it outside the function. Okay? It has its own lifetime. It has its own region where only it is available. Okay? So this is what called as scope, variable scope. Part of the program where variable is accessible is called as variable scope. Okay, here, okay, this is the scope of x inside the function. So there will be different type. Okay, so there are four type in the variable scope. First one is local, second one is global, third one is enclosed, fourth one is built in. So we'll discuss about this in the next tutorial. Okay, we'll discuss about this with the LEGB rule. Okay, so for now don't worry about this. Just remember that we can't access all the variable from the all the part of the program. It has its own lifetime, it has its own scope. Okay, so next you can see which names are present in the current scope. Okay, so using dir function, which is the built-in function, so we'll see that now. So here when you'll start the IDLE, now if I use dir and enter, we can see all the built-in names. Okay, okay, so now if I just create a variable num equal to 10, now if I see dir, it contains num also. Because here num is defined, it is the name, so that's why here we can see in the name list we can see num also. Okay, so here if you want to see, first I'll print dir, I'll define a function n is equal to 10, here I'll see dir, here I'll take num is equal to 20. Sorry, should print this. If you want, it is initially inside the function. Outside the function, save this and run this. Here we can see initially these are the names present. Outside the function we can see these are the names. Here we can see num and f1, okay, the function name and variable name, and we didn't call this function, that's why it's not printing anything. Just call f1 now. Here we can see initially these are the names, built-in names. Next, inside the function only n, because it has its own namespace. Okay, this is the scope of this variable, and in this current scope only one name is present, that is n. Next, here outside the function we can see this f1 and num, not n, because n is belongs to that function itself, so it is not available outside the function. Okay, so this is about the namespace and variable scope. Namespace will control all the names in the program. It will allow us to reuse the names in the different namespace. We can't access all the variables from the all the part of the body. The part of the code where variable is available is called as variable scope. In Python, namespace are implemented as dictionaries, key and value pair. Okay, here key is nothing but name, value is the object, name object mapping. So that's it for now. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.